Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today let's take a look at 10 useful and fun things that you could do with GarageBand on your Mac. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 700 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign. Join us and get exclusive content and course discounts. So GarageBand is a great free app that comes from Apple. You can get it from the Mac App Store if you don't already have it. And you may have looked at it before and thought, well, this looks really cool, but there's nothing I could really use it for. So here are 10 simple things that you could do with GarageBand. Some of them useful, some of them just fun. First, let's look at trimming a simple audio file. So with GarageBand started up here, I'm going to create a new project, a new empty project. And it's going to ask me to choose a track type to start with. GarageBand is picky about that. It always wants to have one track, even if you're not going to use it. So we can choose software instrument or audio. It doesn't really matter. Either one of those and hit create. We'll get a GarageBand window here with one track open. Now don't worry about that empty track there. We're just going to drag in an audio file. So I'm just going to drag that in from the Finder. I can stick it here. If I created that microphone track here, I can just drag it into there. Otherwise, I can create a second track. It doesn't matter which one. You drop it in and then you'll see the waveform for that audio. You can hit play and it will play that audio.
This is a test audio file.
And you can click and drag here and move around in the audio file. If you want to trim some of it, you can go to the end here and you see how you have controls here at the end. You want to grab the bottom right hand corner, click and drag, and you can trim from the end. You could also click and drag the bottom left corner to change the start point. Then you can drag the entire thing and you want to drag it so it locks all the way to the left. So now I've trimmed a little off the left, a little off the right. Now all I need to do is go to Share, Export Song to Disk, and export a new copy. And you see I have a variety of formats that I could use when I export and options for them all. Now you can also use GarageBand to just record your voice. So let's start over again with an empty project. This time I'm definitely going to choose the microphone here, and then I'm going to go to GarageBand Preferences and to Audio MIDI and make sure my input device is set to my microphone. Now to record my voice, I just need to hit the record button. I'm going to turn off the count in and metronome before I do that. And now I can just talk. This is a test. This is me recording. And you can see I just hit stop there and now I have this recording. I can trim it. I could go to the end here and hit record again and record more. And then when I'm done, I can go to Share, Export Song to Disk again, and export it as a regular audio file. Now you can also use GarageBand to easily merge audio files. So I'm going to start an empty project again, just choose the microphone, and I'm going to drag that same test audio in here, but then I can drag in a second test audio and stick it right there. And you could see I could move them closer to each other, I could trim each one and move them around, and then I could preview by hitting play, and then export the entire thing again. And you could string together 3, 4, 5, as many as you want audio files to merge them together and export a single plain audio file from them. Now you can also filter audio very easily. Now I'm going to go create a cycle area by clicking here. So this creates a little area I can adjust that will loop over and over. So if I hit play,
this is a test audio file. I'm going to count to 10. This is a test audio.
I can just hear it loop. So now let's apply an effect to it. If you don't see the library here on your left, click on this button to reveal the library. And then with this track selected here, you should see here some filters. Let's go to voice filters. And I can select one of these. Let's play this and I'll show you some different voice filters.
This is a test audio file. I'm going to count to 10. This is a test audio file. I'm going to count to 10. This is a test audio file. I'm going to count.
I'm going to count to 10. This is a test
audio file. I'm going to count to 10.
So once you've applied one of those filters, then exporting will include that filter. Now you can also use GarageBand to play your Mac like it's a piano. So let's start with an empty project, but this time I'm going to choose software instrument. I'm going to hit create. And you should see this little keyboard pop up here. Let's dismiss it for now and note that I've got an instrument set here, in this case classic electric piano. If that's not the one you want, you can go here on the left and there are all sorts of other instruments you can choose. So I can go to piano and choose Steinway piano for instance. Now let's bring that keyboard back up. It's under Window, Show Musical Typing. Now if I click on this, like I click here, it actually plays that note. I can even click and drag. Or I could type using the keys shown here. So A, S, and D are C, D, and E. Now you could move up or down octaves by clicking here or using the Z and X keys. So you can go down an octave, up higher. Now if you click here, it switches to this type of keyboard and you have to click with your mouse, but you get a larger keyboard. Either way, it's a lot of fun to play and you can change the instrument here. So for instance, I can change to a synthesizer, go with classics and maybe this one, and I get different sounds. It is just something fun to play with, but if you hit record, it actually records those notes and now I can play them back. So how about drums? You could have fun with drums one of two quick ways. One is instead of choosing a software instrument or a microphone, I can choose drummer. Hit create and you're going to get a drum track here and you have all of these controls. From your library here on your left, you can choose from a variety of different types of drummers, select one, and then select a different beat for that drummer to play, and then hit play to hear it. Let's turn the looping on here and just play this. Now I can go and change what's being played by moving this dot around from loud to soft, simple to complex, and by changing which parts of the drum kit are used. So watch as I play around with this. And this is a real track just like those audio tracks. So if I wanted to, I actually just could export this. If I wanted this to loop longer, I could click here at the top right and drag this out and have this loop for a long period of time. Export a 5-minute track that's just drums playing. Another way to play with drums is to use them in the same way we played with the piano and synthesizer before. I'm going to create an empty project, select software instrument, but I'm going to switch the instrument here to drum kit. And then select a drum kit like this one. Now when I use ASD or any of these other keys, I get drum sounds. And they map across the different kits. So a bass drum is the same key on the different kits. So you can get used to kind of playing things and then switch the drum kit to something else. And just like with the piano, you can record things. Now another thing you can do is you can use various loops that come with GarageBand and create your own little music. It's really easy to do. Just create a software instrument there. I'm going to close this and I'm going to click on loops here at the top right. Then I'm going to go to genre and select something. So let's say it's like jazz here and you can see there's some drum kits. So clicking once will just give you that sample there. Drag that in to a new track here. We can get rid of this track. I'll click on it and hit Command Delete to delete it. Now we just have this drum track. I can stretch out the loop there and I can find something else. So go down this list here and here is some bass. Let's drag that in and let's loop that all the way out. And now it'll play them together. You can continue to add 3, 4, 5, 6, as many as you want of these loops and have them only appear in places. So for instance, I can shrink this down, move it over, and now we'll hear drums first and then the bass will come in the second measure. You can create quick little loops or fun bits of music here, export them out, use them in video projects or whatever you want. Now you can also use MIDI files. So MIDI files have been around for a long time and they're basically musical notes encoded into a digital file. So let's create an empty project here. Just an empty software instrument. And I'm just going to drag a standard MIDI file. You can download a lot of MIDI files from the internet. They've been around for decades. So here's just a piece of classical music. It's just a .mid file. I'm going to drag and drop it in here. It's going to ask me if I want to change the tempo to match and I'll say yes. And now I've got this little bit of MIDI here. It's going to play on a piano. I can play it. I can change the tempo here. So let's boost the tempo way up. Get rid of the metronome sound. And I can even change the instrument. Right now it's set to piano, Steinway piano here. I could go to vintage electric pianos there, go to a classic electric piano and hear it on that. And you can combine this with other loops or even drum kits. So I can add here a drummer like we showed before, and there'll be a drum kit here. GarageBand will match the tempos. So now you get something like this. See how easy that was to create? And finally, let's look at editing video. Yes, video in GarageBand. That's kind of weird because GarageBand's just for audio, right? Let's create an empty project here. I'm going to choose just a software instrument as the blank track. And I'll get rid of it, but after I add a video in. So I'll drag and drop a video file in here and I'll add it in. I get this little video window here. I can shrink that down because here I'll see the audio, but as I scroll through it, this will show me where I am in the video track. I can actually play it. This is a test video. Now I can get rid of this extra track here. And I've got the audio in here. I can apply filters to it just like I can do with the regular audio track.
Count to 10. 1.
I can add other tracks to it. So I can add music or anything I want to it. And there's so much more you can do in GarageBand, of course, that I'm not even going into. And once you're done with this audio, it can be exported back into the video. So you go to File, Movie, Export Audio to Movie, and it will take this audio track and it will create a new video with these settings using your now changed audio track. So if you haven't used GarageBand much in the past, I'm hoping these 10 ideas will give you a chance to take a look at it. GarageBand's a useful tool, but it's probably also the most fun tool that Apple provides for Macs. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.